that's another part of me. The Sound of Music is that kind of dimension and way of thinking. That's also, that was very important for me, I think, when I was a kid.
The movie.
Yeah, I thought about that. That's coming out yet. Yeah,
Do you,
all that kind of thing. When the one when you're afraid and you have to think of beautiful things and whatever, and butterflies and I don't know what, and birds and flying and all those beautiful things. Hi, I'm Paolo Borza. I was born in Dublin, living in Rome, and I'm 45 years old. My dreams as a child, I always remember when I was like really small, being with my mother or one of my older brothers or sisters, queuing up in the supermarket and looking at the cashier. This is like early 70s, and I'd see her, the numbers and all that, and I felt she was very important and I wanted to be a cashier in the supermarket when I was a child. I didn't get my dream, my dream didn't come true. Anyway, I want to specify it's 27 years I'm living in a non-English speaking country, so if my English goes a bit bonkers every now and then, don't worry, I'll get to a conclusion.
Okay, good.
And maybe I say a few words in Italian so you can underline them. Again, to describe myself, I'd probably go to my childhood days. I remember when we were young, when I was young, in Italy we'd go walking. I'd go walking with my mother or my parents, and they always like these big groups. Cousins, friends, going to walk in this rural Italy where my parents came from, and I'd always kind of walk on the side of the wall where it's kind of dangerous, or kind of wander off. That child is still me in a certain kind of way. Then with other things added on, life and experience and whatever, but that child there is still me. That's me. The most important element in my life, I think, it's love for people. But at the same time, I think the most overrated thing in life is love as a couple. Like, I'm gonna say something very unpopular now, I think, like, couples are boring and I prefer individuals also to speak to. I find when people are like in a couple situation, they talk to you in a cryptic way. They're not free to say what they want to. I find them more interesting when they're in individuals. But I think the most important thing in life is people, love for people, as people, for what they are and for their characteristics and for the things you can learn from them. A happy moment in my life was when I declared to my mother a few years before she died that I loved her. And it wasn't easy because you feel silly, you feel kind of embarrassed to say these type of things, which is the most natural and was the truth also. But I found a moment, I was trying at it for a few years. And I found a moment when she said something to me, I said, this is the moment I can tell her, like, that I didn't feel silly, it felt right, you know, when things just feel right. And it was kind of a declaration of love, and I was really happy about that. She died, like, a couple of years later. and I'm happy I told her that at that moment. That was a big moment. It was two very difficult moments of my life are because it's related to the age, is gonna be the latest is when my brother died like 3 years ago. He was like a year and a half in hospital and in Rome, and I was going, like he got an operation like to lose weight, and it didn't go good, and so he was basically suffered like for a year and a half in hospital, every day in Rome going to see him. Like, it was also beautiful in the sense, it was beautiful like being with him and comforting him, like just being there, but it was definitely probably the most difficult moment in my life, like seeing a person there like after a year and a half, like every day being injected and taking things out of him and taking blood tests and all that, and then he just dies. So you kind of think like all that suffering of a year and a half that just goes in vain, like just he died. And seeing a person towards the end when he knew he was gonna die, seeing a person who knows they're gonna die, that was definitely one of the most difficult moments of my life. He was when he was dying, the moment he was dying, like I was speaking to him when he died. So I hope in some way I tried to sweeten his death, make it more sweet. So I hope I got that done. If I had one wish, I'd wish I could have a million wishes. Apart from that one, which is probably not allowed in the wish, I wish that all the people I've known and I've loved and I've experienced would come back. You know, as you said, you know, I can find beauty in tragedy. It's more a question of surviving. You know, it's the only way to survive the tragedy is by seeing a beauty in it in a certain kind of way, to make it more acceptable. Because, like, you know, when unpleasant things happen or tragedies happen, they're very, very difficult to survive. So you have to find a way of surviving it, of overcoming it. So in a certain kind of way, you have to make it beautiful.